Welcome back to Dark Souls 3. Let's go and get my souls back. By the way, after the end of the last episode, I realized that this place looks like the very beginning of the game. I mean, of course I noticed some of the enemies seem to be from the beginning, but... yeah, this entire place actually seems to be from the beginning. In fact, this is where I started the game, right up here, right? Yeah. In that coffin is where I came out of. And that's where I found that, that ring. Yeah. So why am I back at the beginning of the game, but things are different? How strange. Got their weapons, I think. Warden twin blades, that's it, right? Paired weapons wielded by the Grave Wardens of the Cathedral of the Deep. The Grave Wardens of the Cathedral, who put down reincarnating corpses, wield weapons that cause profuse bleeding, for the loss of blood and bodily fluids is said to slow reanimation. Oh, I heard you. I did 420 damage and then 666 damage. Beautiful numbers. Such cool enemies. Whoops, didn't mean to unequip that. Alright, let's finish reading that. Set to slow reanimation. Oh, that was the end of it. Special attack is slicing a foe with a large spinning motion. Who cares? Let's just see what it looks like. No point in reading it when I can just do it. Ah, is that one of those ones that I can continue going? Mm-hmm. Although only for one more attack, it looks like. If you do it once, that's that. If you do it, and then a strong attack, does that. What if I do it, and then a quick attack? It just cancels out of it. So how are the stats? Oh god, the scaling is horrendous. That scaling is so terrible. Yeah, I would never use that. It just would not work for my character build. I went forwards, right? Yeah. I'm assuming I'll get invaded again? Or maybe not? Oh my god. Oh my god. I'm an idiot. Well, rip my souls. I let starter enemies kill me. Why? Alright, well, since I don't have to worry about my souls, let's go to other areas first, because I think going down there, the way I was going, is definitely the main place. So I've already been up there. Hold on. These are not enemies that should be repeatedly killing me. Just to make sure this... Yeah, okay. I've already been there. There's somewhere else that had a couple pathways, though. I don't remember where that is. Was it up here? I know there's a dog that way, and then it just loops around. Where were the other pathways? Uh-oh. Bad! Bad! Doggies. Maybe it's better if I go this way. Yeah, I'm trying to remember this place based on how it was in the beginning of the game. I remember that's where I fought the first massive lizard over down that way. I wonder what's there now. I think that was the only pathway, right? Yeah, that was the only pathway. It's either forwards or to the big lizard. Good puppies. Luring it out. Wow, level designers were creative, huh? Players revisiting the area. What's harder than one big lizard? Two big lizards. Alright, let's try to get one at a time. Could try a bow. Oh. That works. Guess I'll fight it, like, right here. Man, they're just easy now. Good advice. Especially not very difficult. I'm pretty sure if I had to fight two at a time, I probably would have died. Okay, let's not do anything stupid this time. These enemies honestly don't... I feel like they're maybe not any more difficult than they were at the very beginning of the game, so dying to them is just embarrassing. Is there an item to jump to here? No, this time there isn't. Wasn't there an item on top of that thing before, and now it's just off it? But there's a message, and I want the message. Aw, come on! Hidden Blessing. Do I already have one of these? No. Fully restores 8 FP. So I wonder if the boss in there is going to be like a souped-up version of the boss. That'll be interesting. There used to be an enemy down there. Aww. Visions of plunging attack, indeed. Very sad. I'm gonna backstab you. Come on. I heard it coming behind me. Little shield can't stop me. If only I had a lonely butthole. What the hell does that even mean? Alright, what's waiting for us? Champion ahead there for a try rolling. Well, I'm used to that. Looks the same so far, but I doubt it's the same. Try parrying. It's not gonna happen. So, I mean, like, what's gonna happen after I defeat it? Am I gonna get to go through the doors, and am I gonna get to experience, like, a dark, different version of the entire game or something? Is this New Game Plus? I mean, it can't be. New Game Plus can't happen until after you finish the game, right? What is that? Oops. Ooh, requires a lot of strength. Really good base damage, though. Damn, and it's a halberd. Oh, it's a halby. The scaling, though, is terrible. Even if I had the strength to use it, the scaling is really bad. Glaive of the Black Knights who wander the lands. Used to face chaos demons. The unique attack of this glaive greatly reduces enemy poise, reflecting the tremendous size of the enemies that the knights have fearlessly faced. Greatly reduces enemy poise. Interesting. So it's really good at, I guess, stunlocking enemies? I'm assuming that's what poise does. Apparently they actually, I don't know if I ever mentioned this before, but they changed the function of poise in Dark Souls 3 compared to the previous ones. And from what I've heard, it doesn't have nearly as much of an effect as it used to. So I don't know if poise even really matters anymore. It's a gorgeous weapon. Whew, very slow. So it's a fast attack, let's do a strong attack. And special. Oh, that's cool. Yeah, it seems to really be a common thing that you can do the special. If you press the left trigger, it does the special as always, but if you press the right trigger, it sometimes extends the attack. It seems to be a pretty common thing, and that's the same for this. Here's the special attack, just holding the special attack down once. And then if I do the special attack and then do a normal strong attack during it, it does this. Kind of continues it out to another big swipe. It's a really cool weapon. If I was going with another halby, I'd love to use this thing. But I don't have the strength and its scaling is terrible. So not the weapon for me right now. Oh, I don't have to pull out the sword. Alright. I think that's new. Whoa! Ooh, I'm lucky that missed. Jesus Christ! Freaking ninja! Oh! Is it still gonna transform into a crazy creature with red eyes? Christ! Grab me. Well, it hasn't transformed yet, so oh god. So maybe it doesn't transform, it just goes red. Interesting little remix of the boss. Whoa, what is it doing? Ugh. Christ. Oh, fuck! Oh. Jesus! Bad, 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 bad. Oh my god. fuck! Please let me rest, I'm out of Estus, holy shit! Fuck! Oh, thank god! Oh, I did it! Ooh. You know what, when I defeated the last boss, I forgot to check to see what I could soul transpose with the soul. I should do that soon. Would there be victory indeed? I'm just curious, am I gonna be able to open this door? And if so, then is this New Game Plus? I feel like it might be, actually. If it lets me just keep going, I think this is New Game Plus that I maybe can access it before actually finishing the game? I don't know. It sure seems like it to me. I mean, it's the same as the original levels, except, like, enemies are a bit different, they're kind of remixed. Obviously, they're harder. But yeah, I think this is New Game Plus. Huh. Interesting. It's an interesting way to do it. I don't actually remember how New Game Plus worked in Dark Souls 2. But I'm pretty sure it didn't work like this. Alright. Well, I guess I'm done with this place for now. Let's go back and check out my soul transposed possibilities. So, white dragon breath. Or moonlight greatsword. Anything else? Nope. Okay. Legendary dragon weapon associated with Seif the Pale Drake. Charge strong attack to its limit to unleash moonlight wave. Osiris, the consumed king, was infatuated with the search for moonlight, but in the end, it never revealed itself to him. Draw sword back and thrust to unleash torrential moonlight. Sounds really cool. I kind of want to try it.
Treat the firekeeper.
Requires... Oh, it's very much a magic weapon. I might not be able to do the torrential moonlight thing. Let's see. Yep. That's a Final Fantasy sword. That's a quick attack. This is a strong. And special. Oh no, the special does work. So wait, how do I charge it up? It said charge it up all the way to unleash. So the skill is draw sword back and thrust to unleash torrential moonlight. So that's what I've been doing, but I don't see any sort of moonlight, so I'm not sure what that's about. Maybe it's because of my lack of mage skill. Charge strong attack to its limit to unleash moonlight wave. So is that the special attack that does the moonlight wave, or just the normal charge attack? That's a strong attack, fully charged. Huh. Oh well. Let's let's level up a bit, and then I guess go back to the princess.
Very well, then.
Two levels up. Let's get some more health and some more dexterity.
Farewell, Ash of May the Flame.
It's been a while since I fought this boss. Now I've fought a bunch of other bosses before fighting it again. Hopefully I haven't lost all my knowledge of its moves. How do the bonfires work in that dark other world, the New Game Plus or whatever that is? How do you tell it whether you want to go to the same bonfire in the dark world versus the light world? Alright, so I've already got the ember. There's a couple more things I need to set up, though. A bunch of things I bought for this fight. What were they? One is a general resist thing. Some sort of... yeah, moss fruit. There we go. That, and then... something else. This? Lightning? I think it was that. Or maybe it was that, or maybe it was both, I'm not sure. I'll use lightning. Ugh, press the button! There we go. Don't know how long this stuff lasts, but let's go ahead and use it. Why did that make me... okay. Apparently that stuff is full of lots of nasty chemicals. Forgot about that move. All right. Here we go. Oh, right. Shit. Forgot about that move too. Shit.
Rocks are great,
rip.
But you may rest here too. if you like.
Alright, well, hopefully I'm through the relearning the fight phase. I really don't know how long that fruit lasted for. I'm assuming it let up maybe around the same time as the pine resin? I'm not sure. It's pretty easy to tell when the pine resin disappears because the flashy effect disappears from the sword, but I'm not sure about the fruit. Is there an effect of the fruit? Oh yeah, there's that little kind of subtle effect on me, but I can also look at the top left, just under the stamina, that little plus up with the picture of the person. I don't really look there during fights though, so it's not really something I'm gonna see. Too well. Really not doing too well. Moss fruit disappeared. Duh! Oh, almost couldn't dodge that. Done like almost no damage to the younger prince. Not good! Okay, just about to happen, and... Alright, target her. Dodge, and then... Okay, did a lot of damage. Yeah. Looking really good. I'm definitely gonna be able to kill the younger prince next time I kill the older prince. Yeah, it's looking good. Yes! That's it, right? I think that might be the end of the game. Cinders of a Lord. Did it. Good job. That was a really nice fight. Alright, what are these cinders? Are they a key? They are a key. If the lords will not return to their thrones themselves, then let them return as cinders. The Lothric bloodline was obsessed with creating a worthy heir, and when this proved impossible, resorted to unspeakable means. Suffice it to say, the path to linking the fire is a cursed one indeed. Seems to be no way up. So what do I do with that key? I'm assuming I go back to the shrine bonfire and do something with the thrones? Let me see what I can soul transpose. Oh, damn it, wrong one.
Aha.
Lothric's holy sword. Terrible scaling, and requires faith or something like that. So, not good for me. Prince Lothric's straight sword blessed by Emma with potent magic. Young Lothric was meant to be a champion, and was expected to wield this platinum sword. But some things will remain distant dreams forever. Lorien's greatsword. Alter greatsword of Lorien, Prince Lothric's older brother. Cast in smoldering molten steel and stained black. Before Lorien embraced his brother's curse, it was a knight who single-handedly slayed the demon prince. But the victory eternally scorched his sword with flame. Very cool weapons. Definitely none of them for me, but very cool. What about the stats on this one? Just requires pure strength. And does fire damage. I want to see this thing work. It's strange that this one costs souls to transpose and the other one doesn't. I wonder why. I'm never gonna use this thing, right? Probably not. Let's do it. Where is it? Oh, there it is. The icon for it's so muddy. Man, that looks cool. Fast attack? I can only get two of those off before I'm out of stamina. Strong attack. And special. Wait, what? Is that supposed to do something? Oh, do I need to do that and then do an attack? It seems like it. That plus strong attack. It's weird, though. Doing just this itself takes up FP. I don't know why. It doesn't seem to do anything. Lunge forward to transform smolder into flame and follow with strong attack to launch flame across ground. Yeah, that stuff just doesn't work for me. I don't know. It doesn't... The weird thing is, I thought I'd be able to do it just because it doesn't require any sort of, like, intelligence or faith or anything like that. But I guess not. I don't really know why. I really just don't know how magic works at all.
Welcome, host. Very well, then take it.
Two levels up. Let's get some more stamina. Some more dexterity.
Farewell, Ashen.
Alright, so what do I do with this thing? Do I go to, like, the big throne? It says it's a key, so obviously it unlocks something. I don't think that writing was there before. Does it get added every time I defeat one of them? This one's for Lothric. How did they get into this seat? Did they fall from above? They must have fallen from above. I think you can get on that. Yeah, you can walk up there. Oh, here we go. What now? It's very creepy. Whoops. Do I have to do that for all the other ones, too? Oh. I guess I could have done that all along and just didn't even know. Because, you know, the game doesn't tell you, like, anything. Oh, she's moving.
The five lords sit their five thrones. All thanks to thee, most worthy of lords. Ashen One, with the lords as thy witness, bend thy knee afore the bonfire's coiled sword, and let the lords' embers acknowledge thee as their true heir. A true lord, fit to link the fire. Farewell, Ashmay the Fool.
Let's do it.
Noble lords of Cinder.
No!
The fire fades.
Rest in pieces.
And the lords go without thrones. Surrender your fires to the true heir. Let her grant death to the old gods of Lordran, deliverers of the first flame.
Kiln of the first flame. Granting death. So, seems there's perhaps one more fight left before the end, huh? Well, I don't know about you, but I'd say that is a pretty good place to end this episode. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and when I return, I think I will commence with the final fight.